Okay, so today we are going to start a very important another branch of mathematics. This is vectors and three-dimensional geometry. Vectors and three-dimensional geometry, one by one we will study. So first, vectors, vectors in which vectors your first basic properties of vector, basic definition, because it is another branch of mathematics, so basic terms you must know about that. So those things, addition, subtraction, scalar multiplication, those things, and then dot product, cross product, triple products, and some geometrical applications, and then we will go to 3D. 3D again, basic three-dimensional geometry, direction, cosines, direction ratios, distance formula, those things, and then in 3D, how the straight line will be there, what is its behavior, what are the various properties, and then planes. So these are our basic concepts we will cover in this part of maths. So today we are going to start with vectors. Vector algebra, vector algebra. So first we'll go through the basic definitions. Scalars, quantities having only magnitude but no direction are called scalars. Vectors, quantities having both magnitude and direction are called vectors. Example, velocity, acceleration. These are some examples of vectors. Scalars, temperature, speed. These are scalars. Vectors having quantities which have both magnitude and direction are called vectors. So now the thing comes that how you will represent a vector. Representation of vector. Vectors will be represented by a directed line segment. Vectors are represented by a directed line segment, means if this is called A, this is B, suppose. So if I should mention an arrow here, so this will give you the direction, means this is a vector whose direction is from A to B. This point A is called your initial point and B is called terminal or final point. Terminal or final point. So this vector, simply this is the vector which is there. I will write this as A, B, ho, bar. This is the notation. If you write only A, B, means it is giving its length. Bar means direction from A to B. If suppose this length is A, then we will also write this as A bar. This A will give you the magnitude. So here magnitude is what? Is A, B or small a, which is generally denoted by mod of A. Mod is nothing but represent the magnitude of that complex number. So direction is very important. See that A bar, simply at A is nothing but its magnitude, length, and this bar indicate that some direction is there, initial to terminal point, A B bar or A bar, you can mention like this. This is the representation of vector. Write down. So now, Since it's a new chapter, some special definitions on some various types of vectors. Types of vectors. First one, zero vector. Zero vector, you can understand that. Name itself says that magnitude should be zero. Vector whose magnitude is zero. So first thing, magnitude is zero. Now the second question arises that then what is its direction? Magnitude is zero and have any arbitrary direction. Having any arbitrary direction. You can't say that vector having no direction. If it don't have direction, you should say that it's not a vector. So if zero vector, we are talking about the vector means it must have some direction, and that direction is arbitrary. It can have any direction. And generally, simply a point is nothing but your vector, or this is generally denoted by O bar, or you can write like this A bar or B bar. This is nothing but your null vector. Same point, initial point and terminal point should be same, then it is called a null vector. Then second direction, parallel vectors. Two vectors having before going to this, I want to tell you a small thing. So I hope you understand this zero vector. Now, characteristic of vector. Every vector have three characteristics. Every vector have three characteristic. Two you already know, they are in the name itself. What? Magnitude, first one, magnitude. Second one, direction. And third important characteristic is line of support. What? Line of support. Means suppose this is the vector AB bar, which is A bar. So one thing is length, that is AB. Other thing is direction from A to B. Now if you observe that this vector is a part of a line. Observe that this is the line in which this vector segment is the part of that line. This line is called your line of support. What is it called? Line of support. So now come to the definition of parallel vectors. Now if I will talk about the parallel vectors, then the definition will be two vectors having same or parallel line of support are called parallel vectors. Parallel vectors means, see that, suppose this is vector A bar and this is another vector B bar. We will say that these two vectors are parallel if these two lines, which two lines? For which these two vectors are part of the line. So see that if these two lines are parallel, we say that these two vectors are parallel. See that this is another vector. Suppose C bar, A bar, C bar, A bar, B bar, B bar, C bar are also parallel because they lying on the, they have the parallel line of support or same line of support. Hence they are called parallel vectors. Now in parallel vectors again categorized in two different ways. What? First one, again two different types, like and unlike vectors. Like and unlike vectors. Two parallel vectors are called like vectors if they have same direction, if they have same direction, and two vectors are, two parallel vectors are unlike vectors if they have opposite direction. They have opposite direction means one thing is common, the vector should be parallel. After that only we can categorize whether they are like or unlike vectors. So see that this is A bar, this is B bar, and this is suppose C bar. They have the parallel line of support, you can see that. But observe that A bar and B bar have same direction, so these two are like vectors. But see that A bar is going in this direction, C bar is going in the opposite direction, so these two are unlike, these two are also unlike vectors. But for unlike vectors, first of all they should be, first of all they should be parallel, mean their line of support should be parallel. After that only we will talk about like and unlike vectors. Next definition, co-initial vectors. Two or more vectors are said to be co-initial vector if they have same initial point. If they have same initial point, then the vectors are said to be co-initial vector. See that this is A bar, this is B bar, and this is C bar. All the vectors are starting from this point, suppose some O. Now you can see that they have the same initial point, so these vectors are called co-initial vectors. Write down. Next definition, unit vector. Vector of magnitude 1 unit is called यूनिट वेक्टर जनरली डिनोटेड बाय कैप ऑन इट. मीन सपोज आई विल से दिस इज अ वेक्टर हुज लेंथ इज वन यूनिट, दिस इज ए बार, सो आई विल से इट इज ए कैप. इफ देर इज ए कैप ऑन सम वेक्टर, यू शुड अंडरस्टैंड दैट दैट वेक्टर इज विच टाइप ऑफ वेक्टर, इट्स लेंथ विल बी वन यूनिट. सच वेक्टर इज कॉल्ड यूनिट वेक्टर हुज लेंथ इज वन. सो इफ यू विल फाइंड कैप समवेयर, यू शुड अंडरस्टैंड दैट इट्स लेंथ इज हाउ मच, वन यूनिट. सो इफ सपोज दिस इज सम वेक्टर ए बार, व्हाट सम वेक्टर ए बार, सो इफ यू डिवाइड ए बार बाय इट्स मॉड, एंड नाउ इफ यू विल टेक इट्स मैग्नीट्यूड, व्हाट यू विल गेट, मॉड ए बाय मॉड ए, दैट इज हाउ मच, वन. सो व्हाट इज द मैग्नीट्यूड नाउ, वन यूनिट. सो यूनिट वेक्टर इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ a bar is a cap is equal to a bar by mod of a bar. Means if you want a unit vector, if you want a unit vector in any vector's direction, so just divide by its magnitude, you will get the unit vector in that direction. Write down. Next, equal vectors, two vectors are said to be equal if they have same magnitude and same direction. Important thing is their magnitude should be same and direction should be same, then we say that the two vectors are equal. Suppose this is a vector a bar whose length is suppose 5 units. What is the length? 5 units. Here is another vector which is exactly parallel to this, having same direction, and if it is 5 unit, this is also 5 units. So simply we will say that A bar is equal to B bar. Means if this is A bar, this is also A bar, you can take here also, this is also A bar, you can take here also A bar, here you can take A bar, anywhere you can take this A bar. The only important thing is all the length should be 5 units and direction should be same. Then such a vector is called, then the three, all these vectors are equal vectors. Direction should be same, magnitude should be same, then the vectors are called equal vectors. Next definition, free vectors. Vectors whose initial point is not specified are called free vectors. Are called free vectors. Anywhere you are taking, this is A bar, this is B bar, this is C bar, like that, anywhere you are taking, then such a vector is what? Free vector, whose initial point is not specified. But suppose this is your A bar, this is B bar, this is C bar. Now I will give you the next definition, localized vector. Localized vector. Vector parallel to a given vector parallel to a given vector whose initial point is fixed, is called localized vector. Suppose I will say this is the fixed point, generally it will take O. So suppose this is your A bar. Now when we talk about the localized vector, you must take A bar from here only. Now see that this is free vector starting from anywhere, but now this is localized vector because it must start whose initial point is always fixed. Suppose this is your vector B bar, but I will not take this as the vector. Now I will take parallel to this but starting from O only. So see that this B bar is localized, this is free anywhere you are taking, but here your initial point is fixed. Then such a vector is called localized vector. Generally that initial point is always origin. Again see that suppose this is a vector C bar, but I will take parallel to this same magnitude but starting from C. See that these are localized vector but these are free vectors. Did you understand? Localized vector means parallel to a given vector but starting from a fixed given point, then such a vector is called localized vector. Write down. Negative of a vector. Let A bar be a vector, then the vector B bar whose magnitude is same as A bar but direction just opposite to the direction of A bar is called, let A bar be a vector, then the vector B bar whose magnitude is same as A bar but direction is just opposite to the direction of A bar is negative of A bar, denoted by B bar equal to minus of A bar. Means if suppose this is your A bar, then same length but direction should be opposite. This is minus A bar, this is minus A bar. Direction should be just reverse but length should be same. Then such a vector is called negative of that vector. Write down. Addition of vector. This is also called parallelogram law of vector. See that. Suppose A bar is a vector and B bar is another vector. We have to add these two vectors. So suppose this is O, this is A. So come on, tell me, this is B bar. Can I say this is also B bar? How? I'm just taking the vector parallel to this with the same magnitude. This is also what? B bar. Now observe that what I'm doing is taking A bar, OA and OB as the sides, I am forming a parallelogram. Suppose this is the point C. Now, if you join OC, this OC bar is nothing but OA bar plus AC bar, but AC bar is also equal to B bar. So, what is OA bar? A bar plus AC bar is B bar. This is nothing but your addition of two vectors. So, how you define? If addition of vectors, see the definition now. If A bar and B bar are adjacent sides of the parallelogram, then diagonal of the parallelogram, let OA bar equal to A bar and OB bar equal to B bar be adjacent sides of the parallelogram, then the diagonal of the parallelogram OC bar is defined as the sum of A bar and B bar. Observe that OA bar, OB bar, their initial point is fixed. So that diagonal which is passing through that initial point will give you the summation of those two vectors. OC bar is nothing but your sum of A bar and B bar. That is, OC bar is equal to A bar plus B bar as shown in the figure. So what you should understand that if this is the parallelogram, A bar plus B bar will give you this vector A bar plus B bar. This is the vector A bar plus B bar. Did you understand? So and this is nothing but called your parallelogram law of vector. So from that parallelogram, now I am considering only the triangle. This is O, A, C again. This is A bar, this is B bar, this is your A bar plus B bar. A bar plus B bar. Or if I will give this as the name B, so OA bar plus AB bar will give you OB bar. See that OA bar plus AB bar will give you OB bar, or AB bar is equal to OB bar minus OA bar. Remember this, later we will use this when we will go to the position vectors, there we will use this. So come on, tell me, if again I am drawing a parallelogram with this is A bar, this is B bar, O, A, B, C, suppose. So if this is A bar, this is also A bar, this is B bar, this is also B bar. See the figure, as I told that O, B bar is O, A bar plus A, B bar, which is A bar plus B bar. This is your O, B bar. Any problem? Any problem? Now observe the figure again with the same logic. O C bar plus C B bar is also O B bar. Agreed? So O B bar is equal to what is O C bar? B bar plus what is C B bar? A bar. Observe that in these two your left hand sides are equal. O B bar, O B bar. So can we say that A bar plus B bar is equal to B bar plus A bar? That is, addition is commutative. what? It is satisfying the commutative law. So like this only, can you check associativity? Quite easily you can check that A bar plus of B bar plus C bar is equal to A bar plus B bar plus C bar. Quite easily, just take another vector and this will be quite easily you can prove this result. Then, you only tell me that. Suppose A bar plus O bar means suppose this is your A, B is your A bar. So A B bar plus B B bar will give you A B bar or not? Come on, tell me. A B bar is your A bar plus B B bar is your null vector is equal to, again you are getting. So what is this? Additive identity. What is your additive identity? Null vector will give you the identity vector. Identity vector means if you add any vector to that one, again you will get the same vector. Then, if A bar plus B bar is null vector, then B bar is nothing but minus of A bar, inverse of A, additive inverse of A bar is minus of A bar. If you add A bar with its negative, you will get a null vector, isn't it? So this is your additive inverse. What is the additive inverse of A? Minus of A bar. Null vector, additive identity, null vector. A bar plus null vector will give you A bar. So these are the basic things. Come on, tell me. Again, I am drawing a parallelogram O, A, B, C. Suppose this is A bar. This is, if this is B bar, what is this? Minus of B bar. Agreed? Agreed or not? So, and this is what? A bar again. Observe that. C B bar plus C A bar B A bar will give you C A bar. Again, triangle law. C B, see the figure? C B bar plus B A bar will give you C A bar. Will you agree? So can I say that C A bar is equal to C B bar A bar B A bar minus of B bar? Agreed. Means what do you understand from here? That if A bar and B bar are adjacent sides of a parallelogram, then A bar plus B bar will give you a diagonal of the parallelogram whose initial point is coincide with A bar and B bar, and A bar minus B bar addition will give you one diagonal and subtraction, difference will give you the other diagonal of that parallelogram. See that C A bar is A bar minus B bar. Did you understand? One addition will give you one diagonal whose initial point is coincide with A bar and B bar, and difference will give you the other diagonal of that particular parallelogram. So, can you tell me the geometrical meaning of when mod of A bar plus B bar is equal to mod of A bar minus B bar? What does it represent geometrically? What does it represent geometrically? See that if A mod of A bar plus B bar equal to mod of A bar minus B bar means in a diagonal, in a parallelogram, both diagonal lengths are equal. But this happens in the case of rectangle. So mod of A bar plus B bar equal to mod of A bar minus B bar means A bar and B bar are adjacent sides of rectangle. agreed? Or we can say that A bar is perpendicular to B bar. This is a geometrical meaning of mod of A bar plus B bar is equal to mod of A bar minus B bar. Now, again see that if this is your A bar and this is some B bar, then if I will join this O, A, B, this is your A bar plus B bar. Observe that what you know that O, A bar, O, A plus A, B is greater than O, B, isn't it? Why? Sum of two sides of a triangle is greater than third side. So, O, A mod A plus A, B mod B greater than O, B mod of A plus B. Or can we say that? Can we say that mod of A plus B less than mod A plus mod B from this? Can we say? Now observe that if A bar is this and from here your B bar is this, so what is this total? A bar plus B bar. In this case, if you observe that mod of A bar plus B bar is equal to mod A bar plus mod B bar, means these two results if I will combine, I will get the result that mod of A bar plus B bar is less than or equal to mod A bar plus mod B bar, and equality holds if the two vectors are collinear. Collinear means if the two vectors lie on the same line, then the two vectors are collinear vectors. So equality holds when the two vectors are collinear. Remember this very important result. Okay. Now from this only another result will come, that mod of A bar minus B bar. Come on, tell me, can we write this as mod of A bar plus of minus B bar? Can we write? Which is less than or equal to mod A bar plus mod of minus B bar from the above result. Just now we had proved. So mod of A bar minus B bar less than or equal to, can I write mod A bar plus mod B bar? Because modulus of B is same as modulus of minus B. So mod of A bar minus B bar is less than or equal to mod A bar plus mod B bar. You have to remember these two results. Write down. Now come on, tell me, can I write mod A bar as mod of A bar minus B bar plus B bar? See that B bar and B bar cancel, you are getting the mod A bar again, isn't it? And this is less than or equal to mod of A bar minus B bar plus mod B bar. How? Just now the result which I had proved, that mod of A plus B is less than or equal to mod A plus mod B. Now bring mod B in the left hand side. So mod A minus mod B less than or equal to mod of A minus B. Did you understand? Now, come on, tell me, what is mod of B bar? Can we write this as mod of B bar minus A bar plus A bar? Same thing. So, which is less than or equal to mod of B bar minus A bar plus mod of A bar. Bring this A bar in the left hand side. Mod B minus mod A is less than or equal to mod of A minus B. Any problem? Why? Mod of any number is same as its negative also. Now see that I want to ask you a small thing, that if x is less than a and minus x is also less than a, can we combine these two results and can we say that mod x is less than a? If x is positive, this will happen. If x is negative, this will happen. So can we combine these two results like this? So now observe that mod of A bar minus B bar is less than this, mod of B bar minus A bar is less. This is negative of this. So combine these two results. Can we say that mod of mod A bar minus mod B bar less than or equal to mod of A bar minus B bar? Remember this result also. Okay. So these are the some properties of addition of vectors. Now one very good problem. With this problem we will stop today's class. Problem is, if sum of two unit vectors is a unit vector, find the magnitude of its difference. Find the magnitude of its difference. First of all, your question arises that how is it possible? So see that this is suppose a unit vector a cap. This is another unit vector b cap. Then their sum is a cap plus b cap. This is again a unit vector. This is possible if this triangle is equilateral triangle. See that one unit, one unit, one unit. This is a cap, this is b cap. OA bar plus AB bar will give you OB bar. This is also a unit vector. So this is the condition given. You have to find the magnitude of their difference. This is the question, isn't it? So come on, tell me. If this is b cap, if I will go one unit only in the opposite direction, this will be your minus of b cap. Agreed? Suppose this is the point C. So if I will join OC, so you can see that OC bar is equal to OA bar plus AC bar. OA bar, A cap, AC bar, B cap. So minus of B cap. This is your OC bar, difference of those two vectors. So its magnitude we have to find. So observe that this is angle how much? 60 degrees. Why? Because this triangle is equilateral. So what about this angle? 120 degrees. Agreed? Then only total will be 180 degrees. So see that in triangle OAC cos 120, cosine rule is OA square plus AC square minus OC square by twice of OA into AC. Agreed? Cosine rule. What is cos 120? Minus 1 by 2 is equal to OA length 1, AC length 1 minus OC square by 2 OA 1 AC 1. So 2 to cancel. So OC square is how much? Minus 1 will go there. Plus. So OC is how much? Root 3. So what is the magnitude of their difference? Root 3. If sum of two unit vector is a unit vector, then the magnitude of their difference is root 3. Still later when I will give you the dot product, again I will solve this problem. This way that will be much smaller, easier. That result again you will do, but this is something, a better way to solve this problem, some logical way. Okay. So this is something about addition of vector. Still some many more things we have to study in the next class, that we will continue that. Scalar times of a vector, how it represent, what it will give, then section formula, position vector, collinearity of vector, coplanarity of vector, all these things we will continue in the next class.